Hello, and welcome to another World of Tanks replay. This time I am in my Super Pershing, the T26E4. I am platooned up with Nurkus, she's also in her Super Pershing. And it is a tier 8 game on Murovanka. Which, with one arty, so not too bad. But yeah, I picked this replay because it gives me a good opportunity to talk about this tank. I bought this tank during Christmas because I thought it would be a fun tape premium tank to have. It has special matchmaking and the armor seems to be quite good. And it's just a different flavor than all of the other. The Mut, for instance, you can see driving around here in this game is sort of just another tier 8 premium medium tank, similar to Pattern and CDC. And the Pupa Pershing would be would allow me to will allow me to train up my Pattern crews. So that's nice. And as you can see here on this map, as stuff that is always happening in World of Tanks these days is that your team goes all to one side and then you either steamroll that side or the enemy swoops around and kills you in no time. But yeah, it's just life. So yeah, I set up here on the hills because the Super Pershing is a Pershing in the sense it, well, it is a Pershing with more armor. So it has a good gun impression, a good 90mm gun, and good turret armor. The Super Pershing especially has good turret armor. Sadly, my gun gets taken out quite quickly, and this is not the most accurate gun in the game, but I decided to leave it as it is for now because I'm going close in. And here again, the whole snowball effect. We have all of our tanks here, so I know we need to push this a bit aggressively, so I start to push in. One thing that's worth noting about this tank is that the pen is not fantastic. It's 170 on AP and 200 and something on APCR, so you need APCR to be able to go through an ice completely frontally. But, yeah, I mean, that's easy done. There's arty. And there we go, killed the two heavy tanks. So now that's cleared up enough, as in, now we can turn around and deal with what is about to roll into our base. That was the whole goal of that push there, that our heavies weren't really pushing. So I needed our heavies to just go, so I, yeah, charged ahead. Luckily the front armor of this tank is really good, so you can bounce quite a bit off the front. Oh, pardon, that was a yawn for those of you wondering. Oh. But yeah, because there's only one arty and we're Super Pershing, me and Nurkus, we take up defensive positions here. just sort of to be able to sit, hold down, and have them shoot up at you. The Super Pershing has two weak spots on the turret, or a weak spot, I suppose, and that's the cupola. But if you aim down on people, it's a lot harder to hit this weak spot. So that's definitely how you want to do it. And here now you can see our team making a complete mess of their push. And they're all dying now. They should have pushed with the E25s, and one they did was a Ferdinand, but yeah, such is life. So me and Nurkus, we're sitting here just trying to hold all of these tanks at bay. Lots of tier 8 mediums in this game, but luckily we get the the right tank for for the defensive positioning. I'm angling a bit like this so that the Comet and STA and so on looking over there, like you see there, still won't be able to hit my side. If I'm angled flat on them, side onto them, they can easily pin my side because it is still only a Pershing. The Super Pershing only has frontal armor on the front. Just quickly pause. You can see here, that extra plate that's here is the extra armor it has, and then these plates. So nothing here, so it's still very vulnerable, and around this as well. And the weak spot I was talking about is this one. But also you can see you can pin here, and then just above, basically don't hit these plates and you should pin. Sort of roughly. Of course, on the upper plate you won't... lower plate can still sometimes pin. And upper plate as well if you have insane APCR pin. But here again, as in Nurkus and I, we're just sitting holding this position. We can't really do much. We're super Pershings. If we move out in the open, we will just get wrecked from every side. So we have to let people come to us. Here I'm just blind firing that STA's position, hoping to hit him. There he is, not paying attention, but pinned me casually a bit. That's the part of this armor. I'm trying to look where he even pinned me, and I don't know. I think that was a cupola hit. And again, hit by the comet. This is another thing with the super Pershing. Sometimes the armor works really well, and sometimes it just doesn't work at all. And there you can see pin marks from this comet. Most likely firing APCR, which I don't blame him, as in I would do that as well in his APCR, or in his comet. But now he's dead, and that's good. But he was a pain in the ass on the side. It's a quite even game. It is actually one of the better games, which is also why I chose it, in a long time. Because it didn't just end in 5 split seconds, as it usually does. And the comet is QQing about camping for the WNate. But, yeah. People complain all the time. You can't do anything right in this game anymore. I mean, he was sitting in the same position all game like we are, so... Glass houses, my friend. But, yeah. It's not looking too good, but it's not terrible either. We're still 5 top tier tanks. And they're quite low health and we have strong positions, and they have one tank less now. So now we just, again, have to sit in here. I don't know what their arty was doing. Oh, he was shooting our ISU. And now there's an 88, and they are not fun. High pin. And OI is not fun either. So I just have to get out of here. That was an AP shell by the OI, but he's dead. But that would have been quite good, because that means he can't pin us easily. But anyway, this is Jagdtiger 88, there's an SCM. I'm 2 shot from him, so I can take a hit. From him, not the 88. Or as in, from either of them. So pushing on, you have to be careful. Can't quite get that guy, and I think this is where I take a hit from the... Oh no, I don't, okay. But here's a Jagdtiger, he's moving up. I've loaded APCR because the Jagdtiger's armor is strong enough to withstand 170mm of pin. And he hits me there, which is not good. Nurkus is also one shot. He went straight through my mantlet. So I mean, if you have high enough pin, you can go through everything. So now we just sit here sort of with this Jagdtiger pinned down a bit. But we just have to wait a bit. Our career is moving up on the side now. And we should have, I think we have this under control. We have more guns than they do, and we're all more or less one-shotable, but we can turret lock them, which means that if they're looking at one of us, we can shoot the other one. Here's the Jagdtiger. I snap a shot because it's APCR, so I can. I'll just, to show you, APCR has 258mm of pin. So it's almost 100mm more penetration you get from shooting to APCR. It's very strong. And yeah, but now it's just cleaning up. And this the CDC and the Korea, they did well, and I tell them in chat. And then they went YouTube, and we were joking on on TeamSpeak that we know. But I mean, yeah, I mean, this was a good, strong defensive position for us to just sit and, yeah, soak up pressure. And it was a fun game because you had to think around and keep aware of all of the angles all the time and stuff like that. So it was, yeah. And this ends up being a master batch, mastery ace tanker batch, as you can see in the post-game stats. Which I will jump to as soon as this game is done. We just need to find the Ati. He's there, behind something. He fired. I just try to roll into cap, see if I can get some cap points. And I may get one, if I'm lucky. Yeah, I got one. Two. There we go. So yeah, let's head over to the post-game stats and have a look. So here we have the post-game stats. You can see Ace Tanker, first mark of excellence, high caliber, steel wall. It's good. It's all good. And then the one I was a bit surprised by during this game, I did 4,200 damage and 1,500 base XP with the four kills. I mean, that you didn't really get the sense of that in the game, that I did that well. But apparently I did. It also helps that I got 1,300 spotting damage and I blocked 1,500. As in, this is the steel wall, 1,500 damage by armor and 9 shots bounced. So that was nice. And then the joys of having a battle or a high tier credit bonus, premium account and a premium vehicle running is that you make a butt ton of credits. So that's fun. But yeah, as you can see, sort of, yeah, just when the game is slow, a slow tank like the Super Pershing can really influence it well. And this shout out to this Arty guy for not shooting at me or Nurkus too much. That was nice. He had a good game, but it was nice that he didn't shoot at us. So yeah. Oh, and before I forget, this will be the last World of Tanks replay in a while, because I've decided to take a break from the game. I need to try something new. I'm getting burned out way too quickly already from World of Tanks. So I would let my premium account run out and then only play the occasional session once a week, maybe once every 10 days. Just once in a while, log on, play a bit, have fun with some friends. It's just, yeah, I felt it's time for me to move on and try new games. So you can expect to see some CSGO coming up on my channel once I've I've gotten some my skill level up to a point where it might be fun for you to watch and not just me running around dying all the time. So yeah, but other games will pop up as well, just like, I mean, I have the Lone Dark already running, and yeah, we'll see. I have other fun games I'll have on the channel. So yeah, I've also left Fame as a consequence because I don't want to hog a space in that clan. If I'm not going to be active, because they have a lot of people who want to join and want to be active and part of the community, and I want them to, yeah, be able to do that without me sitting in the corner, not being active and having a spot. So no Fame, but there's nothing wrong with the clan at all. It's just my own inactivity that I feel doesn't allow sort of lava all over again, I suppose, but now it's even worse. So no clan for me for a long time. I think I'll just relax and have fun as it is, solo, play with some friends. Now I can now I can be a mercenary for other clans if I want to, so that's always fun. But anyway, enough chit-chatting. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to ask away down below, as per usual. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed it, this video. And I will see you for my next video, whenever it'll be. So yeah, take care, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.